Okay. Yep. It's me. AVT. Ooh, it's hot. I'm going to have to take off this shirt, like, right away. And it's not really even that hot outside. It's humid. And so it feels like it's going to rain. So I don't really have anything to say, but I'm used to blogging, and I usually blog once a day, if not twice, or depending on if how urgent the situation is. So I have absolutely nothing in particular to blog about, but I do want to say something about a couple of things. I want to say something. First thing, pray on this cat that created a car bomb in Times Square and is willing to take the lives of innocent bystanders. I mean, a pregnant woman with a child in her arms could have walked by when those, if that had exploded. And so I want to say praise to God and glory to God and praise God, Father God in heaven, in Jesus' name, that this did not happen. In the name of the Holy Spirit, I give him praise. I mean, in the name of Jesus, I give the Holy Spirit praise. I give God the Father the truth and the light. In the name of Jesus, I just want to give him all the glory and thanks that it did not light. It did not blow. And that a man saw it and saw it smoking, and that the police officers were there to take it, and that nobody got hurt. Glory to God. I want to say that this is very, 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 very serious ordeal. And that this guy, they need to catch him. They have all this surveillance and cameras and stuff like that. That this random act, we don't know who did it. We don't know if the good guys did it, the bad guys did it. We don't care. We just want to do caught. Somebody is responsible for this. Okay, so I think that, you know, that this needs to really be this, you know, I just don't like how the news is covering this. This is Times Square. Matter of fact, you know, I saw this McDonald's down there, and that was my hanging spot. So this dude was going to blow up my hanging spot in the McDonald's. I mean, can you imagine that? This is like, you know, and can't imagine how many countless of people. But, you know, you're sitting in a McDonald's and then explosion. This is just ridiculous. And for anybody to think that they can do that, you know, one of the reasons why I left New York is because, one of the reasons is because I don't have time to live with that. I don't have time to deal with that. You know, I understand it can happen anywhere, here, there, anywhere. But, you know, it's just tragic that somebody would do that in the middle of Times Square. Like, how brazen is that? You know, and then run away. The coward was trying to protect his own life. You know, so, you know, this needs to really be, this guy needs to really, you know, I hope they really catch him and throw, you know, I hope they catch him. Let me say it like that. I'm not condemning or judging him. I'm just saying, I hope they catch him for the crime he has committed. Okay? All right. So, it is not my job to judge him or the sentence that he would get, because it might not be righteous. Well, so, so speaking of sentences and stuff, there's a police officer who was tasering kids, tasering young children, or tasering teenagers. Okay. Matter of fact, he tasered 20 teenagers. 20 teenagers with one taser. So after the first, so obviously the kids asked him, begged him to taser them. There's about 50,000 taser videos on the YouTube. So it's about 50,000 of them on the YouTube of kids asking to be tasered. So after the first one got tasered, then it was 19 more that asked to be tasered. So I understand that the policeman should not be letting the kids feel the taser, but obviously they wanted to be tasered. So they're talking about sending this man 23 years in jail for a child endangerment, for kids wanting to be tasered. You know, he might have stopped. He may have saved our society from 20 criminals who might have been, or at least 19. Let's say if he did the first one on purpose. At least 19 criminals, I'm sure. Future criminals don't want to be tasered, okay? So I can understand it was irresponsible and stuff like that. But they're kids, and kids like to do stuff like that. No, they didn't ask him to shoot them or anything. It's a taser. They see it all on the YouTube. So even though it's responsible, he should have been done, and he should be recommended, but it was really a misdemeanor kind of thing, you know? I mean, to give him 23 years, to give him any jail time for that, what you need to do, you know, to give him any jail time for that is just ridiculous. You know, to give him any kind of, you know, maybe a check, you know, or two weeks, no check. You know, and I'm not trying to judge him, and because you know, but I'm not judging him. What I'm saying is that what he's facing right now is too harsh. The judgment that is already on him is overkill. You know, they were young kids. Yeah, it wasn't no 10-year-old or 9-year-old or nothing like that. I don't think. You know. I don't think so. And anyway, when none of them harm, and if any of them complain, they should learn from the other 10. If you got 10, they should, at least if they're going to charge them and sentence them, give them for the first three, give them, you know, maybe a couple of months or something like that. But after that, the first three, like from 3 to 10, then give him a week for those. And then any one of them that was stupid enough to ask to be tasered after 10 to 20, then give him 1 to 2 days. They know what they were doing. They were having fun. And, you know, kids are experimenting and stuff like that. It was probably no different than kids asking to be put a fire mask on their face. You know, when you're for a fire engine, is there any fire on? No, you don't cut off their air supply, but you know, it's probably asking just like, can I have your hat on or something like that? It's just not that big a deal. When you should be cautious of that, when you see a woman on the ground and she's begging and pleading for the cops to stop tasering her and electrifying her body, when she's laying on the ground defenseless and can't move and they have it on her for 10 seconds. You know, $50,000 for 10 seconds. You know, that's ridiculous. You know, that's when you should be charging them, the ones who you need to be sentencing, you know, 2 and 3 years for misconduct, you know, or when somebody is getting shot 40 times or 50 times, you know, these are kids, they were acting up, it was irresponsible, maybe he shouldn't have done it. But, you know, kids going to see that in YouTube and want to know what it's like. He might have done us a favor. Maybe he saved us from some future criminals. Okay? So, I wanted to say that. And somebody told me that Sarah Palin wrote on her hand, her notes. She's a grown adult, right? She's supposed to be governmental. She, what? Obviously, it is too cold in Alaska. Because it is slowing. It is the brain cells. It's just like, It's just a little bit, that's, you know, what grown person do that? Read a card if you can't remember it. You're a candidate. I do not trust this woman in charge of men or a country that has to fight enemy territory. Sorry. They're not leaders, okay? So, that's stupid. That's just plain stupid. Or, you know, if you want to compete with Obama and you can't memorize it, just write it on a card. You know, nobody cares if you look at a card and forget a point, you know? Just because Obama is a genius like that, you don't have to be. Everybody, you know, she's not even a good cheat. How you gonna write a cheat sheet? Write your government official notes on your arm. Oh, God. Anyway, America, don't ask her to leave me, please. Do not nominate her. And last thing, I'm gonna just say this in general. Don't air all your dirty laundry out on, I mean, you know, there's situations, but everything, you know, some things you should keep private. Certain family members, matters, you should keep private. You know, I understand there's a need for people to explain stuff, but certain things you keep to yourself. Anyway, I should have ended before I said that, and I really shouldn't say what I'm talking about, but somebody, if somebody heard it, they'll know what I'm talking about. Anyway, God bless you all, love you all. I'm trying to stay cool. It's humid. You know, I've been loving the Buffalo weather. It's been mild, and so it stays kind of cool in this room, but it's going to get hot pretty soon. Love you all. Talk to you all, and I don't have anything else to say right now.